Good morning, all of you. This is exercise 8.3, comparing quantities. Question number 1. Here in this question, it says calculate the amount and compound interest. You have to calculate first of all, you have to calculate the amount, and then you have to calculate the compound interest. For the first question, it is rupees 10,800 for 3 years at 12.5% per annum compounded annually. Means here, first you have to find out the amount and compound interest. The formula of calculating the amount is principal into 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. And for compound interest, you have to write down the formula amount minus principal. What you have to do in this question, first we will see what is given to us. Here P, it stands for principal. Second, R, it stands for rate. The percentage, whatever is given in the percent, that will be in the rate. And N, and here it denotes the time period. Okay, principal, rate and time. So here what is given to you, the first question, 10,800 is the principal. So 10,800 is the principal. Rate, it is given 12.5%, means 12.5% rate is given to you. And time is for 3 years. So what is given here? 3 years. You have to find out the amount and compound interest. So first of all, we have to find out the amount. After finding the amount, we will get the principal, and this principal we will after finding the amount, we will find out the compound interest. So let's start with the amount first. Amount is equal to principal 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. So the principal here is 10,800, okay, multiplied by 1 plus r. R is rate. Rate, it is given in 12, 1 by 2. You can make it into the, this is given in the mixed fraction, you can convert into proper fraction. So 12 to the 24 plus 1, that is 25 upon 2. So I'm writing here 25 upon 2. This 100 is in the denominator, so it will be multiplied with 2 to the power n. N, what is given here? N is 3. So I'm writing here as 3. Now solve this. 10,800, on multiplying you will get 25. This you can cancel as 25 ones are 25 fours are. So here you will get 1 upon 8 to the power 3. Similarly, on solving this, you will get 1 upon 8 to the power 3. So this is LCM 1. You can take in the denominator as 1, nothing is there. That means 1 is there, so LCM is 8. So what you will get, 8 plus 1 upon 3. So this will be 10,800 into 9 by 8 to the power 3. So as this is 9 by 8 to the power 3, you can write down this as 10,800 into 9 by 8 into 9 by 8 into 9 by 8. So on solving this, you will get 1537.34. Okay, and this is the amount. You have calculated the amount here. So on solving this, you will get this much amount. The second one is, what you have to find? You have to find out the compound interest. So compound interest, what is the formula for compound interest? You know that for finding out the compound interest, we take amount minus the principal. First you have taken out the amount. For finding the compound interest, you have to write down this amount, and the whatever is the principal, you have to subtract it with this. So amount is 15377.34. On subtracting the principal, principal is given to you as 10,800. Subtract this, okay? 10,800.00. When you will subtract this, you will get 4577.34. Okay, so this is the compound interest. So in this question, first of all, what you have to do, first see whatever what you have to find out, write down the formula for that, and after this what is given to you, write down. If it is in improper fraction, you can convert it into the proper fraction. First we have to find out the amount. We have substituted the in the formula principal multiplied by 1 plus r by 10 upon 10 to the whole power n. Here p is the principal, a principal amount, r is the rate, and n is the time period. On substituting the value, you got the amount here, and now you have to find out the compound interest. So compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. Whatever amount you have taken out, you have to subtract with that principal, and after subtracting it, you will get the compound interest. So this was the question number 1. This is question number 1. Calculate the amount and compound interest, C part. Here the principal is given for 1.5 years, and rate is given 8% per 8% per annum, compounded half yearly. There it was given annually. Annually means per year, and half yearly means these it will be divided by 2, because it is divided by 2 times. If I will take half means half plus half is 12th month, okay? So here what we have to do, we have to calculate 2 times. So here in the time period we will multiply by 2, as it is half yearly, okay? So first the whatever is given, write down that. So here we are given with principal is equal to 62500 rupees. Time here it is given as 1.5 years, and rate it is given as 8%, okay, per annum, compounded half yearly. So what you have to do, firstly here I told, as it is given here half yearly, I will convert this into, I will multiply in the time, multiply by 2, as it is divided into 2 times. So what I will get this year, I will get 2 and 1 3 by 2 multiplied by 2, okay, and this 2 and this 2 will get, so I will get 3 years. Similarly, as the rate it is compounded half yearly, this rate will be divided by 2 also, 2, because it is half yearly, so divided by 2 you will get 4%. So rate is 4% here. Now what you have to find out, you have to calculate the amount and compound interest. So find out the amount here. Amount is equal to principal 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. Now just substitute the value. What is the principal given here? 62500 1 plus r. R is 4% upon 100. What is n? N means time. Time is 3 years. So you will substitute the value here. So what will happen? 62500. If you will multiply this, nothing is there means 1 is there, so 100 is the LCM. On solving this, what you will get? 104 to the power 3. 3 time is there, 62500. Now you can write down this, as the power is 3, write down 3 times. 104 upon 100 into 104 upon 100. You can see this 0 and this 0 and this 0 get cancelled. So on solving this, you will get 70304, okay? On solving this, you will get 70304, okay? Rupees. Now you got the amount here. This is amount. This is amount. What you have to find out? You have to find out the कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट. तो कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट इज इक्वल टू अमाउंट माइनस प्रिंसिपल. कंपाउंड इंटरेस्ट इज इक्वल टू अमाउंट माइनस प्रिंसिपल. व्हाट इज द अमाउंट? 70304. What is the principal given here? 62500. 62500. On subtracting this, you will get 7804. This is the compound interest which you have to calculate. Only the difference is there it was compounded annually, and here you have to calculate it half yearly. So in half yearly, time will be multiplied by 2 and the rate will be divided by 2. This is question number 3. In this question it says that Fabina borrows ₹12,500 at 12% per annum for 3 years at simple interest. And suppose, let's take for Fabina, okay? Here she borrows 12,500 rupees, means here principal it is given as 12,500 rupees at 12% per annum, means rate it is given as 12% per annum, and for time means T, or you can call it as N, it is given as 3 years. What you have to 3 years at simple interest. This is for simple interest. Similarly here what is given? Radha borrows the same amount for Radha is same amount, means principal is same, that is 12,500 for Radha also. So same amount for same time period, means time is also given same, that is how much? What was the time given here? 3 years. So this is 3 years at 10% per annum, but the rate it is changing from 12 to 10%. Here Radha is getting for 10% and Fabina is getting for 12%. Time period 10% per annum, compounded. This is compounded annually. Who pays more interest by how much? Means here we have to find out the compound interest and here you have to find out the simple interest. So first we will solve for Fabina and then for Radha, and after that what we have to find? Who pays more interest and by how much? So who pays more? From the amount we can recognize who pays for, and from how much we will find out the difference of them. So for Fabina, principal is 12,500, rate is 12%, time is 3 years. We have to find out the simple interest. So what is the formula for a simple interest? That is P into R into T by 100. Simple interest, if you have to calculate, which formula you will use? You will use P into R into T by 100. What is principal given here? Principal is 12,500 into R is, rate is 12 and the time is 3 years, divided by 100. This 0 and this 0 gets, this 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. When you will solve this, you will get 4,500. Okay. So what is the simple interest? Here you will get on solving from Fabina is 4,500. And now coming on to the Radha. In Radha it says she borrows same amount, means principal is also same, time is also same, only the change is that she got rate is equal to 10%. You have to find out the compound interest here. So before finding out the compound interest, what is the formula for compound interest? Amount minus the principal. What is the formula for the compound? What is the formula for the compound interest? You have to minus amount minus principal. This is the formula. From here, what you have to find? You have to find out the amount. And the formula for amount is, amount is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. Now substitute principal here. It is given 12,500, R it is given as 10% upon 100, and what is N? 3 years. This 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. You will get 12,500. On solving this, you will get 11 upon 10 to the power 3. As you know, this is 3 times multiplied by 3 times means 12,500 into 11 upon 10 into 11 upon 10 into 11 upon 10. This 0, this 0, this 0 and this 0 get cancelled. On solving this, you will get the amount here as 16637.50. On solving this, you will get amount is 16637.50. Now, after calculating the amount, what you have to find out? You have to find out the compound interest. So, formula for compound interest is amount minus principal. Amount is this much, that is 16637.50. And what is the principal given here? Principal is 12,500. 12,500. When you will subtract this, what you will get? 4137.50. You will be remaining with 4137.50. So this is the compound interest which you have calculated. Now from here you can see your simple interest is 4500 and your compound interest is 1137.50 rupees. Okay, so what from here you can clearly see who pays more interest and by how much. So who pays more interest? Fabina pays more interest because here it is 4500 and here 4500 rupees. Okay, and what you have to find out, how much, for how much what we will do, you will find out the difference. So here I am writing down difference. If you will calculate, that is 4500 subtracted by 4137.50. If you will subtract, then you will subtract this, you will get 362. This question number 4, here in this question it says I borrowed rupees 12,000 from Jamshed at 6% per annum simple interest. Suppose I am borrowing rupees 12,000, okay, from Jamshed, means principal is 12,000 rupees at rate, how much it is given? Rate it is given as 6% per annum simple interest for 2 years, means time here it is given 2 years. What we have to find? We have to find out the simple interest here. Similarly, had I borrowed this sum at 6% per annum compound interest, what amount would I have to pay? Means here it is, in this question it is saying this principal is also same, means this is 12,000 only, rate it is 6% only, and time also it is 2 years. But the thing is, we have to find out the compound interest here. So what we are going to do, so first we will find out the simple interest here. So simple interest is equal to P into R into T by 100. Substitute the value here, you will get 12,000 into 6, rate is 6%, that is 6 and time is 2 years upon 100. So on cancelling this, you will get this 0 gets cancelled, this 0 and this 0 gets cancelled. So here you will get 1440. Here you will get the simple interest as 1440 rupees. Similarly, here you have to find out the, had I borrowed this sum at 6% per annum, here you have to find out the simple interest, here you have to find out the compound interest. So for finding out the compound interest, you know the compound interest is equal to amount minus principal. Okay, first what we have to find out, we have to find the amount. Amount is equal to P into 1 plus R upon 100 to the power N. We have, for finding out the amount, we have to follow the this formula. Now substitute the value. P is 12,000 rupees, 1 plus R is 6% upon 100 and N is 2 years. So on solving this, what you will get? 12,000. On cancelling this, you will get 2 threes are 2 fives are. That is, if I take out the, this is 3 by 50, okay? So now 12,500, if I will take the LCM, this will be 53 by 2. Okay, on solving this we'll get 53 by 50 and the whole power 2. As it is 2, what you are going to do, 12,000, just one more zero will come, and 53 is 2 times, so I will get 53 into 53, 53 upon 50 into 53 upon 50. So on solving this, this 0 and this 0 get cancels, and this 0 and this 0 get cancels. So the amount which I will get here, amount is 13483.20 rupees. Okay, so the year amount I will get this much, and if I have got the amount, I can easily calculate the compound interest here. So compound interest here you will get is amount minus principal. What is the amount? 13483.20, and what is the principal? That is 12,000. Okay, subtract this, so you will be remaining with 1483.20. Now you can easily see simple interest you are getting this much, and compound interest you are getting this much. Which one is greater? So you can easily see compound interest is the greater one. Now what we have to find out? We have to find out by how much. So for how much, what I will do? I will find out the difference. So what was that? Compound interest here is 1483.20, and simple interest it was given as 1440. So on subtracting this you will get 43.20. So by this much it is more. Compound interest is more than the simple interest. Now this is the answer. Number 5, in this question it says that Vasudeva invested rupees 60,000 as an interest rate at 12% per annum, compounded half yearly. Here the word compounded half yearly is the main point of the question. What amount would he get after 6 months? After 6 months means here principal it is given. For the first question I am solving, after 6 months here principal is given you rupees 60,000, time here it is given as 6 months. As it is given in month, we will convert this into year. So 6 months means half year, okay? 6 months means half year, and you know it is compounded half yearly. So in compounded half yearly, whenever half yearly is there, what we do? We multiply it by 2. This 2 and this 2 it get cancelled. So this will be 1 year. So what is the time period you are getting here is 1 year. Similarly, rate it is given as 12%. 12% means per annum it is given, but you have to find out compounded half yearly. So it will be 12 divided by 2. So 2 ones are 2 6 are. So what is the rate percent here? Rate percent is 6%. Now what we have to find out? We have to find out the amount. As you know, amount is equal to principal into 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. Substitute the value you are getting. 60,000 plus 1 plus r is 6 upon 100 to the power n is 1. So on solving this, what you will get? 60,000 upon 100 and 6 upon 100 to the power 1600 into 106 upon 100. This zero gets cancelled, this zero and this zero gets cancelled. So on multiplying you will get 63600 rupees amount for 6 months. Okay, similarly when you have to find it for 1 year, what is going to change? I am deleting from here only now. Okay, the principal here it is given same as second portion I am doing now. Principal is same for both the years. Principal it is given 60,000 only. Rate it is given how much? what is it, 12%, and it is saying compounded half yearly means 12 by 2, that is 6% it is here. Now what you have to find out, you have to find out the time it is given in 1 year. So it is, as it say, compounded half yearly. You know, in compounded half yearly we multiply it by 2, so multiply it 2 means this is time is how much, 2 years here. So what amount would he get? What we have to find out, amount is equal to principal 1 plus r upon 100 to the power n. So what is the principal? 60,000. 1 plus r is 6 upon 100 means this much, and n here it is given as 2. This was for the first question, amount I need. Okay, now for second question I am solving here is 60,000 into 106 upon 100 to the power 2. On solving, what you will get? 60,000 into 106 upon 100 into 106 upon 100. This zero gets cancelled, this zero and this zero gets cancelled. So when you will solve this, you will get 6, 7, 9, 1, 4, 1, 6. So this is